You'll always be there for each other. Their fact is that they can be sweet as honey. Sometimes you'll find they might be just plain funny. The Berenstain Bears. The Berenstain Bears.
If ever you're not sure how to complete a task,
the best way to learn and get help is just ask.
The bears went over the mountain to see what they could see.
The bears went over the mountain. The bears went over the mountain. The bears went over the mountain to see what they could see.
Bear Country Camp, here we come!
Yay!
The best part about camping is sleeping in tents.
The best part about camping is telling stories around the campfire.
No way! The best part about camping is getting there. Oh, we've been driving for hours.
Closer to 20 minutes, brother.
Oh. Well, it feels like forever. Is it true we're going to go whitewater canoeing, Grizzly Ted?
It sure is, brother. You'll all get a chance to try out whitewater rapids and 20-step falls.
Waterfalls and rapids?
It's nothing to worry about, Stacy. Those names sound worse than they are. The rapids and falls are just very gentle currents and dips tailor-made for cubs like you who are new to canoeing. You don't even have to go canoeing until you're good and ready. But if you decide to give it a try, there will be lots of counselors there to help you learn and keep you safe.
Oh, great.
The two most important things to remember at Bear Country Camp is to always wear your life jacket when you're near the water and to have fun.
Sounds like a baby canoe course to me. I'm not going on it.
Oh, I guess we're not gonna go on it either, then.
Here at last!
Yay!
Now that everyone's had a chance to stretch their legs, the first thing we need to do is pitch our tents. Now, don't worry if you don't know how to do that. That's what I'm here for. Who needs some help?
I do!
Me!
Yay! Me too!
Okay, then.
Do you know how to do this, Too Tall?
Of course he does, Scuzz. Too Tall knows everything. Don't you, Too Tall?
Of course. No sweat.
You sure you don't want a hand, Too Tall? I'd be happy to help.
Nah, I've put up lots of tents. Don't worry, I'll show them how it's done.
Okay, guys, just remember, I'm around.
First we,
You sure are slow, brother.
No fair.
You got a head start.
Do you need some help, Too Tall? We've done this a million times in Bear Scouts. I don't need any help. Anyone can put a tent up.
If you weren't sure about how to do this, boys, you should have asked for some help. Next time, okay? Come on, everybody, let's lend a hand.
Sure.
No problem.
Okay.
Yup.
Okay, now, who's up for some crafts? We're going to tie-dye our own Bear Country Camp t-shirts. Has anyone tie-dyed shirts before?
We tie-dyed t-shirts in Bear Scouts, Grizzly Ted.
We also learned how in art class at school.
Great! How about you guys? Do you need a demonstration?
Nah, we know how to do it.
Yeah, we know how to do it.
Okay, everyone, let's have some fun.
You do know how to do this, don't you?
Don't rush me. It's been a long time. I'm trying to remember.
Hmm.
We can show you how to make your shirts look really great, Tootle, if you want.
I don't need any help. I know how to do it. Okay, now I remember. All you do is scrunch up your shirts like this. Then dunk them. Come on.
Okay, let's untie the shirts now, Cubs. We'll hang them up here to dry.
Huh?
Did he say untie them?
What does he mean, untie them?
Hey, maybe that's why they call it tie-dye.
Good job, Lizzie. Nice work, brother. Very pretty, Stacy. Now, don't worry, boys. The same thing happened to me my first try. You were supposed to tie it with strings. That's what gives it those swirly colors. Now, next time when you're not sure how to do something, don't be afraid to ask for help, okay? It's a do-it-yourself sandwich, so make it however you like.
When do we get to try out the whitewater canoe course, Grizzly Ted?
First thing tomorrow, bright and early, Lizzie. I'm going to be there along with a few other counselors to help any of you who haven't canoed before. If you have any questions or need a hand, just ask one of us, okay?
Okay.
All right.
Yep.
Sure.
There's no way we're going on that baby canoe course.
We're not?
But it'll be fun. You don't want to miss out.
We were lucky to learn all about canoeing and Bear Scouts, Tootle. We can give you a few tips if you like.
I know how to paddle a canoe, brother.
Even better than you, probably.
We could even beat you in a race. Right, Tootle?
Okay, then. We'll race you.
You're wrong.
We'll beat you hands down. Right, Tootle?
All of a sudden, I'm not feeling very hungry.
Hey, where are you going?
Oh, Tootle! If you're finished, would you mind getting the lemonade cooler?
I'll give him a hand.
Thanks, brother.
Brother, I need your help.
You do?
Fact is, I don't know anything about canoeing.
It's no big deal. All you have to do is ask Grizzly Ted and...
No way. That's too embarrassing. Besides, Scuzz and Smirk think I know how to do everything. I don't want them to know I don't.
But there's nothing wrong with not knowing something or asking for help, Tootle.
I'm asking you, brother.
I'd be glad to help.
Thanks. So, how do you turn again?
Just hold the paddle still in the water like this. That's great. You're a fast learner, Tootle.
Can you show me how to stop again?
Okay. Just hold the paddle flat like this. Good. Okay, let's take it from the top again.
Hey, how come you guys are sitting backwards?
Watch out.
Sorry.
No, over there.
Okay, first canoe to Big Bear Rock is the winner.
Okay.
Ready, set, go!
Stroke! Stroke! Stroke!
Whoa!
Hey! Stroke! Stroke! How come we're going sideways?
Well...
No, no! Like this!
Watch me. Do what I'm doing, see? Like this. It works.
Hey, it does work.
Way to go, Tootle.
Keep together.
Faster, guys, faster.
Awesome.
Whee! Wow.
Break time.
Yup.
Woohoo! Look at us go!
This is fun!
Woohoo!
Woohoo!
Hi. This is great!
Big Bear Rock, straight ahead!
come, Too Tall.
Yeah, you guys are good.
Good race, guys.
You too.
Did you see us go?
Oh, I have to say, that was pretty impressive canoeing out there. You should all be very proud of yourselves.
And we didn't even know how to do it when we started out.
Yeah, Too Tall showed us how as we went along.
Well, all you had to do was ask for help. There's nothing wrong with not knowing how to do something. That's why I asked Brother to show me how to canoe yesterday.
You mean you didn't know how?
Not until yesterday. Thanks, Brother.
Anytime, Too Tall. Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, right. Right, Too Tall?
Nothing at all. Now, if anyone wants to learn a few canoe tips from an old pro, that's what I'm here for.
Great!
Yay!
All right!
When cubs can't agree, it's always most wise
to meet in the middle with a good compromise.
Good morning, class. Today we're beginning with an exciting new topic, birds.
Aww.
And tomorrow, we'll be going on a bird-watching expedition through Birders Wood and to the Bearsonian Institution to meet with Professor Actual Factual.
But, Teacher Bob, birds are boring.
Yeah, right, Too Tall.
Maybe we could study something really exciting, like dinosaurs.
Actually, birds aren't boring at all. Even though I can see you're not exactly flying high about our new topic, I don't want anyone trying to duck assignments or chicken out of our class trip. And by the way, brother, most experts believe that birds are the closest living relatives of the dinosaurs, even closer than lizards. So I think that makes them pretty exciting.
Wow, I didn't know that.
Birders Wood, huh? Perfect. While they're all looking for birds, we can look for a tree to build our ultimate tree fort in.
Hi, Teacher Bob. Brother told me you're studying birds. You can borrow my feather collection if you like.
That's very generous of you, sister. Thank you. If you're interested, you and Lizzie are welcome to come along on our class trip. Maybe you'll even find a few new feathers for your collection.
Do you see them, Freddy?
Got them, brother.
Oh, look! Wow.
Over there, guys.
Oh, no! Its wing is broken.
Actually, it's fine. That's a killdeer. And when something comes too close to a killdeer's nest, it tries to distract it by pretending to be injured.
Wow, birds really are more interesting than I thought.
We could put the rope swing up there and the trapdoor over here.
Right next to the rope bridge. This is definitely the best tree fort tree in all of Birders Wood.
Does anyone recognize any of these birds?
Nope.
That's probably because all of these birds are extinct, which means that...
None of them are living anymore.
Like the dinosaurs.
Exactly. Very good, boys.
You mean they're gone?
Sad but true, sister. There are also many endangered species of birds, which means...
There's just a few of them left.
That's right, Freddy. And if we're not careful, they could soon become extinct as well.
How can we help them, Professor Factual?
One of the best ways is to protect their habitat, which means...
Taking care of the place where they live.
Right again, Freddy.
I saw one of those birds today. The yellow one.
A yellow popinjay? Are you sure, sister? There are very, very few of them left.
I'm sure it was that one, sitting in a big tree in Birders Wood. Cousin Fred even took a picture. See?
I don't believe it. It is a yellow popinjay, and she's laid eggs.
There she is. I see the popinjay.
Come on, guys.
what are you guys up to?
We're checking out our tree.
Your tree?
That's right. The one we're going to build our ultimate tree fort in.
You can't build a tree fort here. This is the Yellow Popinjay's tree.
Says who?
Says
the Yellow Popinjay. She's already claimed it by building her nest and laying her eggs in it.
That's right, Tootle. You'll just have to find another tree.
No way. The bird can find another tree. There's a zillion good bird trees here, but there's only one tree good enough for our ultimate tree fort.
Maybe it is the perfect tree for a tree fort, but you can't put the Yellow Popinjay and her eggs in danger by building your tree fort in this tree.
Well, it's not up to you, now is it? Come on, guys. We've got work to do.
We've got to do something to stop Tootle and his gang.
Don't worry, sister. We'll do something.
It looks like we're short a couple of appetites tonight. Is everything all right with you two?
Sorry, Mama. Sister and I are just trying to figure out our Yellow Popinjay problem.
Sounds serious. Though I can't say that I know what a Yellow Popinjay is.
It's a bird, Papa. There aren't many left. They're endangered. And Brother and I found one with a nest and eggs and everything in a big tree in Birder's Wood.
That sounds like good news to me.
It is, except that Tootle and his gang want to build a fort in the same tree, even though it might endanger the Popinjay and her babies.
They say it's their tree, and we say it's the Popinjay's tree.
Maybe there's a way you and Tootle can compromise.
What's compromise, Mama?
A compromise is when both sides in a disagreement solve their problem by finding a way to work together.
Both sides usually have to give in a little, but in the end, everyone wins.
Well, we said maybe they could build the fort after the babies hatched and grew up a little.
But they said no. Tootle won't compromise. Only one side can win this. It's either the Popinjay or the tree fort.
I wonder what Squire Grizzly would think about all this.
Why Squire Grizzly, Mama?
Because Squire and Lady Grizzly own Birder's Wood.
Then I guess we'll just have to go talk to the Squire.
And tell him that the Yellow Popinjay is endangered and that we have to protect her habitat.
And so you see, Squire, sir, we have to save the Yellow Popinjay. Please. How does that sound?
Save your breath. Once we tell Squire Grizzly all about our tree fort, I know he'll side with us.
We'll see about that. Huh?
If you cubs are looking for Squire and Lady Grizzly, I'm afraid you're out of luck. They're traveling and won't be back for a month.
Fort!
Popinjay!
Uh-oh. From the looks on those faces, I'm guessing things didn't go very well at Squire Grizzly's.
The Grizzlies are gone for the whole month. Now what do we do?
Do you remember last week when Mama had her garden show the same afternoon I had to deliver one of my chairs?
You and Mama both wanted the car.
Right. So Mama suggested a compromise. She went to her garden show but came home early so that I could deliver my chair.
Mama missed the end of her show, and you delivered your chair a little late.
But when we both gave in a little, we both got what we wanted, to use the car.
Compromising may be a way to settle things, but not with Tootle. There's only one tree good enough for his ultimate tree fort.
Then what about building another, even more ultimate tree fort?
An even more ultimate tree fort in a different tree!
But where is an even more ultimate tree fort going to come from?
That's the part of the compromise where we have to give a little.
We? You mean you'll help us, Papa?
Thanks Papa! Papa.
That's the most awesome tree fort ever! It's the ultimate ultimate!
You may be right, brother, but the important thing is that Tootle and his gang think so.
There's only one way to find out.
Hey, Tootle.
Not again. Forget it. You're not going to make us move.
We're not here to make you do anything, Tootall. You want to build the ultimate tree fort? We came to show you what the ultimate, ultimate tree fort looks like.
Huh? Is that a water balloon catapult?
And an escape hatch with a sliding pole?
You betcha.
I don't get it. Are you guys building that?
No, but we could help you build it.
Here?
We'll help you build it, but in a different tree.
But this tree's the best.
So is this tree fort.
And you're gonna help us build this.
My papa said he'd help too.
Your papa? You've got a deal.
Brother, the Tootall gang might have lost the best tree, but we sure ended up with the best tree fort.
We had to pitch in and help you build it, but we ended up helping the Popinjay.
You know, we never wanted to hurt the bird. We just wanted to build our tree fort.
I know. Now everyone is happy because we all found a way to compromise.
Hey guys, come look at this!
Ooh. Whoa, the Popinjay!
Aren't they cute?
Cute. Yeah, cute.
Yep, they sure are.